We know now that people who have regular sleep are less likely to have coronary disease. And we recommend that people sleep at least 7 hours, ideally 8 to 9 hours a day. Snoring can be a sign that at night times you're not getting enough oxygen. And that stress actually raises your blood pressure. People who snore generally tend to be a little bit overweight, have higher blood pressure, and that can indirectly be a risk factor for not only atherosclerosis or heart disease, but for atrial fibrillation. It's not just the lack of oxygen, it's also the higher blood pressure, the higher weight, so all the factors work together. There are a percentage of women that, despite doing all of the right things, are at risk for what we call preeclampsia, which is an elevation in your blood pressure. So it's a normal process of when you get pregnant that you increase your blood volume. Make sure that you follow your blood pressure. Women are 10 times more likely to die of heart disease than they are breast cancer, something that I think a lot of people don't realize. And it leads to problems because women are less likely when they have symptoms, chest pain, shortness of breath, to actually seek medical attention. People who are around other people tend to be more active. So when you have a friend, go for a walk together and talk with that friend. Go with your spouse, take a walk every day. It's not a simple relationship, but clearly social isolation is an increased risk factor for not just heart disease, but for mortality overall.